Vegas in the early AM.
It's gonna be a nice day today.
Let's hope they let me into the parking lot I'm trying to get into. And hopefully it doesn't take forever to get there. I don't know what I'm doing.
See the first SEMA sign. Las Vegas Convention Center, SEMA. Hopefully they let me in.
All right, we have officially arrived. It took me a while to find this parking lot. I drove around three sides of it and it looked like it was closed. And I parked on the street and started walking. And on that fourth side that I didn't see, it was open. So I went back, got the car, came in. And now I'm right across the street from the convention center. Literally a parking lot, like 50 feet away. So, well, now I need to figure out which entrance to go in. I mean, I know which one it is, but I don't know where it is in real life. So let's try and find the media center. We made it. Show to get to the media center because I didn't have a badge and everyone except for media got their badges mailed to them, so I had to sneak on in there, but we're legit. Running around, it's 9:45 right now, and my Fitbit says I just reached 10,000 steps. That's cool. But been running around a whole bunch, seen some cool stuff. Went back to the media center and had a snack, and swapped out camera batteries because I already used an entire camera battery. But right now, I'm trying to make it to TJ Hunt's 350Z reveal in time. Starts in 15 minutes to see if I can find the booth again.
There's that. can't come up on the stage. So you stoked?
Yeah, I'm really excited. This car has been with me from, this is like one of the first cars I've ever had, so it's come a really long way. I'm really excited to show everyone as you look. Got a few updates, so it's come a long way.
Yeah, it's not red anymore.
No, it's, well, there's red. But we originally repainted this thing all red, beautiful, and when we were designing it, some of the guys compiled it, were like, we have an idea to get rid of all of the red, and I was a little apprehensive about it, but after tweaking it around and playing with a few color schemes, I'm pretty happy with how it looks.
Yeah, I've been able to preview, and I haven't seen it in person, but from the renderings I've seen, it looks pretty awesome.
Yeah, it has a very vintage Valvoline look, so it's kind of like a tip to the hat of old livery styles, kind of old stuff. It's pretty good. Yeah.
Well, let's not keep people waiting too long. Let's do it. Let's pull this cover back.
I bought this car crashed from someone else, like, I don't know, 6 or 7 years ago, to sort of see it take the center stage here and have the whole entire livery design and have it fall the booth was quite a shock. So it means a lot that it's here, and you know, big thank you to Valvoline for investing in us and you know, really taking us to the next level.
We appreciate you. It looks great. Well, can we get back to maybe doing some signings, maybe some pictures, let some people get some cool pics of this thing. I need to have a request next year at your life event. I need to take a ride.
Yeah.
So, and drive it if you want me to.
All right, here's me filling in the deets because I didn't vlog as much as I should have while at SEMA. So TJ Hunt's Valvoline car reveal was super cool. After that, I went upstairs, charged my camera, charged my phone, charged myself with a rock star because I was exhausted. I was running on 3 hours sleep and I'd been at SEMA for like 5 hours already. So I had a long lunch break, charged all my stuff, including myself. And then I went to truck reveal, the Birdie's truck reveal. Super cool. I'm gonna get better pictures of it today. So here's a quick video from the reveal, but I'm gonna get some better photos today, some more photos of that coming. And then after that, I rushed around trying to find Mike Rowe because he was on there, and I had him on my calendar, but the first booth number they had was wrong. So I ended up finding him outside, listened to Mike Rowe talk for a little bit. Mike Rowe and Tanner Faust were talking, along with the guy who owns the world's fastest minivan, the Mercedes R63, and the guy who built the flagship car for Fast and Furious 9. All those dudes were talking, bunch of people around watching, super cool. They finished talking, and Tanner Faust says he's gonna take Mike Rowe on the little drift area the Optima batteries has set up. So I walked down a ways, kind of trying to get away from everyone, and start filming, and that's what this is. There's a nice little surprise after the drift.
Yeah.
So after that little car fire, Tanner Faust stopped, and him and Mike Rowe just kind of got out right there and started getting interviewed a little bit. And I was like 20 feet away, so I was like, oh, I'll go over there. And then like 10 other people gathered around. We're all kind of waiting, just hoping or assuming that they would take some photos with people afterwards. And they're both kind of being interviewed, and we're just chilling. And I look next to me, and I realize that Humble Mechanic is standing next to me. And it was crazy because he was one of a couple YouTubers I was really hoping to see here. I was hoping to see, like, him and TJ Hunt and, like, Adam LZ and stuff. Those are, like, the people I follow the most. And I thought he would be the one person that I was least likely to see because there's thousands of people at SEMA, and he didn't have, like, a booth or anything. So I just assumed, like, I wouldn't run into him. So we're just standing there waiting, and I see he's standing right next to me. I was like, what's up, dude? I'm a super cool guy. We just chatted up a bit while we were waiting for Tanner Faust and Mike Rowe to take some pictures of people, but it's cool. Cool dude. And I got a photo with him. I got him to sign my hat. And then also got a photo with Mike Rowe and Tanner Faust. And then after that, I was pretty happy. I was like, all right, I think I'm good for today. So I just floated around, looked at Ken Block's Audi, and then pretty much dipped out because the Hoonigan, there was no room to watch Hoonigan, so I have to do that today. This is day two, by the way. This is the morning of day two. I'm editing this video trying to get it up, in case you're wondering. All right, that about does it for day one. It's 6 in the morning, day two. Hopefully I can get this video uploaded before I have to leave. I'm going to try. I'm going to throw this footage in there and just, it's going to be rough. It's okay. Day two. End of this day one video. Peace.